I like to introduce Sammy Vasquez, who's not only a sensational up until welterweight, he's also the 2011 PAL champion, Outstanding Fighter Award out of 250 fighters. In 2011 and 2012, he was the All-Army for All Fourth gold medalist. In 2010, he was also, he was also the Armed Fourth gold medalist. And he was also the bronze medalist in the 2009 National PAL, and bronze medalist also in the National League of Clubs. And please allow me to introduce Iron Mike's sensational fighter, Sammy Vasquez.
Hello, hello. How you doing?
Hi, Sammy. Thanks for being on. Sammy, you're undefeated at 13-0. You're facing an undefeated fighter in Juan Rodriguez Jr. on April 18th. Can you give us some opening comments coming into this fight? Tell us about your thoughts going in, and then we'll look to get.
He's going down. He's going down.
That's it. That's it. Yeah. My opening thoughts are this. You know, I train hard. You know, I mean, I do what I'm supposed to do. I'm a family-oriented man. You know, I go to the gym 3 times a day. Always train hard. You know, come home, do what I need to do. Because I know, you know, at the end of the day, when I go to fight, you know, I'm giving 110%. And I feel my training is untested. And there ain't nobody in that ring, you know, who can take me out. Especially this, you know, 11-0 Juan Rodriguez.
All right, great. Thank you very much. Operator, if we have any questions in queue for Sammy or Mike Tyson or any of the guys.
Just a reminder, if you'd like to
ask. Sammy Vasquez was also deployed in Iraq in 2005 and 2006, and then again in 2008 and 2009, representing our country. And real fighting, when you lose, you don't come back.
Hey,
you don't get a
true
rematch in that kind of fighting.
Nope.
Just a reminder, if anyone would like to ask a question, please hit star 1 on your telephone keypad, star 1, and I'll access your line. We still have a question from Jay Calderon from 12rounder.com. Your line is live.
Hey, guys. Thanks for taking the call. My first question is for Mike. You said before that this was a dream come true being a promoter, and so I just wanted to talk a little bit about the future, I guess. How big do you think this dream becomes for you?
Hey, this is capable of being as big as it can be. And I didn't say my dream was to be a promoter. My dream was to find a Showtime, a Showbox, with a major corporation like that. You know, mm-hmm. we're a small operation. Just to be on that is just sensational. I'm so proud to be associated with Sammy Vasquez and the rest of my fighters that we can do that. But I can't do it alone, and that's just the truth. I got the name, but I'm not in that ring fighting. You know, so I'm very grateful to my fighters. Thank you very much, Sammy.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. And my second question was for Sammy. I'm sure you grew up like virtually everyone else watching Mike Tyson, and now effectively he's one of your bosses at least. Is there added pressure to live up to his reputation?
Hey, let me say one thing. I didn't mean to interfere, Sammy. I'm not Sammy's boss. I'm his promoter. I'm not his boss. He's the boss. He's the fighter. The fighter's the boss. I just wanted to put that out there. Thank you.
Your question, there's no living up to Mike Tyson, you know, and who he was. He was a, you know, incredible fighter, incredible heavyweight champion of the world. You know, I'm here. I don't feel no pressure to fight in front of anybody, you know, because, you know, my ultimate goal is to become, you know, a welterweight champ of the world. And, you know, him watching me is a blessing. And for him to take look at me and see the potential that I have, that I know I have, you know, it's just an honor in itself. You know, so to be, you know, I don't have really nerves, you know, in front of everybody. I've been on a bigger stage, like, you know, going to overseas and deploying, you know, like those right there is nerve wracking and is nervous itself. You know, to box in front of these guys, you know, and these you know, champions, you know, it's just an honor. You know what I mean? So there's definitely not no nerves. You know, I'm not nervous to fight in front of anybody or. You know, I'm just excited. You know, I'm just blessed to be here.
Okay, thanks for your guys' time.
Yes, sir.
Our next question.
Thank you.
Our next question comes from Chris Guns with Chris Guns Boxing Show. Your line is live.
Mike, I appreciate your time joining us. Your life's been lived out in the limelight, and we saw your greatest ring moments and your worst personal moments that weren't so personal for you. and we've seen you go to prison, and we saw you try to find yourself in so many different ways. But this time it seems like time and age and life actually legitimately changed you. The Broadway show was great. Your performance in The Hangovers were great. And the way you were man enough to apologize to the people you offended, and your show being Mike Tyson was great, and we saw you apologizing to Evander and having conversations with Muhammad Ali and Jim Brown and many other things, and we saw the Broadway show, like I said. It's all been great. What do you give credit to for this change? And now it seems so much more legitimate. It seems like you're not trying. It seems like it really came to you. What do you think is most responsible for this change?
Anything that I have good, anything good happens to me, it's all, you know, it's from a higher power, you know. I'm not no guy that I can make miracles happen. You know, I'm just very grateful. I'm just very grateful I'm able to do those things. I was able to accomplish things, which I've never been grateful for. Before, I thought I was entitled to everything, you know. But listen, I'm just very grateful to have Samuel want to be in that car, Erickson Lubin, Collado, and all those guys wanting to be involved with me, man. I'm very grateful to them. I'm very grateful to them. They don't really understand because they're fighters. The only thing they focus is on fighting. But they save people. They help people. They give people a different output in life. Yeah, I did Broadway shows and I did some, and I did being Mike Tyson. But this is what I am right here. This is who I am right here. I'm involved with fighters. That's why I want to be around fighters. I want to die being around fighters. This is what I do. This is what I really know how to do. I can entertain people and I can be on television, but this is who I am. This is what I really love doing. I love being around them. So being able to promote them is even an extra feather in my cap.
I'm glad you're doing it.
That's all I know is fighting. That's all I know is fighting. I may be able to do other things, but this is what I really know. This is all I'm about right here.
And being you had the path that you had with Don King and so many other promoters through your life that you had problems with, that many fighters have problems with, I'm sure you want to be a stand-up promoter and one for the fighters.
I'm 100% with these guys.
How did Gary Jonas approach you to put your name on the thing, on the whole banner? It's Mike Tyson Promotions. How did he approach you, and were you excited right away?
No, I wasn't, because I was just really turned off from boxing because of my bitter experience. But he came to me and had another organization that wasn't doing well. They had these fighters that were sitting around that really wasn't doing anything. I believe the people that were with him before kind of took advantage of him. And when he came to me with this opportunity, and I said, let's go for it, okay? And so we started I'm Mike Productions. We had a ragtag pair of fighters. We had to get rid of a bunch of fighters because they were just, you know, freeloading on them, and we just had to clean up shop. And so now this is another process of putting these fighters through the test and seeing if these guys will really represent us. And are they really hungry? Do they want to win championships? Or do they want to freeload and lay around and get paid for nothing? This is really what it's about, you know. I want people that want to win. You know, I want them to go in there and I want them to win. I want them to fight people. I want them to win. I want them to fight to their last breath.
And you're great, Mike, and I'm glad boxing still has you around. And Steven Espinoza, Showtime's been so awesome lately. It's already been talked about a little bit. You brought it full circle, it seems, with first the Mayweather signing, and there's been many fighters that followed. But the network wars are at an all-time high. Wars between the networks and promoters, and that hurts the fans. Is there any way that with your past with HBO, you worked with HBO before, is there any way that you can try to bridge that gap, or do you think that because you have that past and because you were with one network and now you're with the other, does it kind of hurt the chance to bring it together?
Well, to be candid, the main conflicts really aren't network to network, since really the networks don't typically work together. There's only been one time in their history that they did, and that obviously was an event that Mike was involved in the Lennox Lewis fight. So it really has more to do with personalities and promotional alignments. And I think right now that's an unfortunate reality of the sport. I'd like to think that I come to it with very much of a fan perspective.